Hello students, today we are going to study Accounting Standard 10. PPE, Property, Plant and Equipment. So this is all with regards to asset. Asset held for producing goods or providing service, but not for sale. If it is for sale, it cannot be considered as asset. So it should be, asset should be held for producing goods or providing services. How can be it recognized as per AS 10? So we will divide recognition into two parts: how to treat initial expenditure, how to treat subsequent expenditure. First point, initial expenditure. How to treat initial expenditure? Initial expenditure can be in cash or credit. It can be in cash or credit. That can be purchase price. For that, we have to add freight. We have to add non-refundable taxes, no ITC available. Such non-refundable taxes has to be added, plus restoration. But the point is, restoration should be in present value of restoration, plus all direct expenses, including till the ready to use. Very important point, till it, all direct expenses till ready to use should be added. And also borrowing cost, AS 16, that has to be added. Discount and government grants has to be excluded, deducted. So this can be the in case of cash or credit in initial expenditure. What happens when exchange with another asset? Exchange with another asset or by issue of securities. That time, fair market value of asset given or a fair market value of securities issued or fair market value of asset received, whichever is clearly evident, that has to be taken. Either asset given or either asset received, fair market value, whichever is clearly evident. In initial expenditure, last point can be self-construction. Initial expenditure for asset, that can be self-construction. At that time, all costs incurred for construction, whatever the cost incurred for the construction, plus all allocated costs directly related. But point to be noted that internal profits should not be included, that has to be excluded. So this is all about the initial expenditure. That is, first one, cash or credit. Second, exchange with another asset, or it can be by issue of securities. Last, self-construction. So second point, with regard to recognition, subsequent expenditure. We discussed about initial expenditure. Initial expenditure over. Initial expenditure, we talked about cash or credit. We talked about the exchange with asset, another asset, issue of securities, self-construction. These all comes under initial expenditure. Now, subsequent expenditure. Subsequent expenditure. Capitalize only when it future economic benefit are probable. future economic benefit are probable. Very important. You know the meaning of asset, that only. Future economic benefit is probable. That time has to be capitalized. And major important points are, number one, major assets replacement in case of replacement and overhauling should be capitalized and depreciated over its useful life. So replacement should be capitalized. If deferred credit terms are involved, sometimes deferred credit terms will be there. That time it should be recognized at present value, and it would be unwinded over. It should be unwinded over the period. Recognize it as an interest. So present value should be considered in the case of deferred credit terms. One more point is, you know, useful life, residual value, depreciation method should be reviewed every year. Every year review is required in case of useful life, residual value, depreciation method. Another point, any change in price, any change in life, any change in method of depreciation, account prospectively, not retrospectively, prospectively should be accounted. That is remaining carrying amount over the remaining life. Remaining carrying amount over the remaining life. That is the meaning of prospective. Select cost or revaluation method for the entire class of items. Select and apply consistently. In case of retirement of PPE, that has to be stated in the balance sheet, either at WDV, diminishing value method, write down method, or NRV, net realizable value method, at the time of retirement in the balance sheet. In case of disposal, it can be not revalued before or revalued earlier. In case not revalued before, P&L should be is equal to sale price minus WDV. So whatever the profit has to be transferred to P&L. In case not revaluate before, no revaluation done before, then sale price minus WDV, whatever the transfer balance is there, has to be transferred to P&L. Very simple. In case revaluation is done earlier, so revaluation done is earlier, but the profit is there now, then P&L, directly P&L. In case of loss, transfer to P&L, remaining RR transfer to general reserve. Revaluation reserve transfer to general reserve in case of loss. This is the concept of, just concept overview of the PPE AS 10. So now we will understand the concept by questions. Here on questions, XYZ Limited has acquired a heavy road transporter at a cost of 1 lakh with no breakdown of the component parts. So details of component parts not given, wholesome amount of 1 lakh is there. The estimated useful life is 10 years. At the end of 6th year, the powertrain, one of its component, requires replacement, as further maintenance is uneconomical due to the off-road time required. The remainder of the vehicle is perfectly roadworthy and is expected to last for the next 4 years. The cost of a new powertrain is 45,000. Can the cost of the new powertrain be recognized as an asset, and if so, what treatment should be used? First of all, So first of all, we have to see whether it is an asset or not, whether it qualifies for asset. If it qualifies for asset, how to value the cost for asset. So you know original cost plus what is the cost of the new asset. So logic dictates whatever the original cost is there plus new asset cost minus whatever the replacement used assets value. For example, in that case 6 years used, then it is replaced asset. So whatever the used amount value should be deducted. So used asset should be written out of the record. So that should be discounted. That should be the discounted value. So in the in given case, heavy road transporter, they purchase vehicle at ₹1 lakh, useful life of 10 years. At the end 6 years, breakdown happened. Correct? Useful life 10 years, end of 6th year, breakdown happened. They replaced for 45,000. The original cost was the 1 lakh. So original cost 1 lakh. New asset cost, replacement cost 45,000. So what is the used breakdown? First of all, is it asset? If future economic benefit is there, criteria, we have to understand the recognition criteria should be understood. Asset can be considered when the future economic benefit is there and cost is measurable. Basic fundamental concept under PPE. If there is a FEB, future economic benefit, and cost is measurable, then it can be recognized as assets. In this case, yes, 45,000, that new cost component C1, we will consider C1 component is there, future economic benefit is there, it can be used, and the cost is already measured, so it is an asset. Yes, how to treat an asset? This is the concept in case of replacement. Original cost plus whatever the new cost asset minus discounted value. What is the discounted value? That 10 years replacement part is broke down, old part is broke down. Let's make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So at this stage part is broke down, sixth. So we don't know that C1 component, we will consider C1 component, lots of component are there, component 2, component 3, component 4. Component 1 broke down, but we don't know the breakdown of that component. We have only wholesome 1 lakh rupees. So we have to find out component 1. Assume C1 broke down. We have to find out the C1 component 1 value. How to find out? We have to take the present value. What is the present value on this value today? As on today, what is the value? We have to deduct from the new cost of asset. So from from where we can get from the replacement cost. This is the replacement cost, 45,000. So 45,000 we will discount. What is the discount rate? We don't know. So we'll assume 5%. You know how to discount at 5%. You are a master in SFM. Still, I will tell how to do. 1 divided by 1.05 point power. So you will get the 6th years, that is comes up to 0.746. That should be multiplied with the replacement cost. That time we will get 33,570. That should be deducted. So 1 lakh plus 45,000 minus 33,570. That will comes up to 1,45,000 minus 33,570. 11 lakh. Sorry, 1,11,430. So this is the concept. Recognition criteria for asset and the concept. The new powertrain will produce economic benefits to XYZ Limited. The cost is measurable, so economic benefit is there, cost is measurable, hence the item should be recognized as an asset as per AS 10 PPE. Recognition criteria satisfied. So for recognition criteria, you have to see these two items. Point number one, finished. The original invoice for the transporter did not specify the cost of the powertrain, that is the part C1. However, its cost of replacement is 45,000, which can be used as indication by discounting factor of the likely cost 6 years previously. If an appropriate discount rate 5% per annum, here assumed 5%, 45,000 discounted back 6 years amounts to 33,570. How? By calculating discounting factor, which would be written out of the records. The cost of the new powertrain 45,000 would be added to the new record, new asset, resulting in a new asset of cost 1,11,430. So this is the concept with regard to replacement. Discounting. So original cost minus discounting plus new asset cost. We will see the next question. ABC Limited is installing a new plant at its production facility. It has incurred these costs. Cost of the plant, yes, it can be included, of course, 25 lakhs. Initial delivery and handling cost, yes, this has to be included. Cost of site preparation, yes, included. Consultants used for advice on the acquisition plant. So consultation used for the acquisition, so it can be added to the asset, can be capitalized. Interest charge paid to the supplier for deferred credit. Deferred credit should be written off during the year itself, cannot be capitalized. This cannot be capitalized. Interest charges. Estimated dismantling cost to be incurred after 7 years. This is related to the asset itself, so can be capitalized. Operating losses before commercial production, no, cannot be. It cannot be capitalized. So cost of the plant, initial delivery, cost site preparation, consultation, estimated dismantling cost. This is the important part. Interest charges paid on deferred credit terms to the supplier of the plant, not a qualifying asset of rupees 2 lakh. Operating losses before commercial production amounting to rupees 4 lakh are not regarded as directly attributable costs and thus cannot be capitalized. They should be written off to the statement of profit and loss in the period they are incurred. Next question. A Limited has an item of plant with initial cost of rupees 1 lakh. At the date of revaluation, accumulated depreciation amounting to 55,000. So we have written down value of 45,000. Okay. The fair value of the asset by reference to transaction in similar assets is assessed to be 65,000. Pass the generalities with the regard to revaluation. Okay, no problem. We will reduce the asset value. We will eliminate depreciation amount. Correct? So, depreciation account debited to asset. We eliminated accumulated depreciation. That time, 45,000 will be the WDV. Then we will revaluate from 45 to 65, 20,000. So, asset to revaluation reserve 20,000. That's it, I think so. We'll see the answer. Yes, accumulated depreciation to asset 55, elimination of the accumulated depreciation against the cost of the asset, asset to revaluation surplus. The net result is the asset or has a carrying amount of 65,000. Correct. That is 45,000 WDV plus surplus 20,000, 65,000. Next question. B Limited owns asset with original cost of 2 lakh. On acquisition, management determined that the useful life was 10 years and the residual value would be 20,000. Okay, original cost 2, useful life 10 years, residual value 20,000. The asset is now 8 years old. Okay, 2 more years to go. And during this time, there have been no revisions to the assessed residual value. Okay. At the end of 8 years, management has reviewed the useful life and residual value and has determined that the useful life can be extended to 12 years, that is 4 more years, in the view of the maintenance program adopted by the company. As a result, the residual value will produce rupees 10,000. Residual value now decreased from 20 to 10,000. How would above changes in estimates made by the B Limited? Yes, changes depreciation amount will change. Correct. First we will calculate the what is the depreciation for the 8 years. We have to use straight line method. 2 lakh minus 20,000, 1,80,000. 1,80,000, what is the depreciation per year, divided by 10, per year 18,000, for 8 years, 18,000 into 8, so 1,44,000 will be the accumulated at the end of the year, 1,44,000. So what will be the written down value? 2 lakh minus 1,44,000, 56,000 will be the written down value. After 4 more years, 2 years extended, that means 4 more years, 56,000 minus 10,000, we have residual value now 10,000. 56,000 minus 10,000 divided by 4, we have 4 years now, so 11,500 will be the depreciation. So it should be charged to the P&L account. We will see the above changes in estimate would affect in the following manner. The asset has carrying amount 56,000, correct? WDV at the end of the 8 year, 2 lakh minus 1,44,000. As we know, they explained how they calculate depreciation amount. 2 lakh minus 20,000 scrap value, 2 lakh minus scrap value 1,80,000, 10 years divided by 10 years 18,000 annual depreciation. So for 8 years 1,44,000 accumulated depreciation, 12 years means 4 more years, so 56,000 minus scrap value 10,000, 46,000 divided by 4, 11,500 per annum. Next question. Determine if the following cost can be added or subtracted to the invoiced purchase price for the initial recognition of the cost of the asset. Okay. Consultant fees for choosing new asset. Of course, this is with regard to new asset should be added. A trade discount received of 5% of the purchase price of the asset. A trade discount received of 5% of the purchase of the asset. Okay, if there is a no asset, no discount, so it relates directly related to the asset, so it should be added. A discount received for paying the invoice within 90 days, of course it should not be added, subtracted, it should be excluded. Number four, interest paid on a short term loan taken to provide the necessary cash for payment of the purchase price. Interest paid on short term loan taken to the provide the necessary cash for payment of the purchase price. Why should it should be added? Should be excluded, not related to asset at all. Import duties paid. Of course, if it is import duty paid to the asset, it should be added. Shipping cost and cost of road transport. Of course, it should be added. Insurance for the shipping should be added. An economic development rebate from the state. An economic development rebate from the state. Yes, of course, it should be added. Added in the sense, it should be considered. Included. 8th point included. VAT paid on the purchases should be excluded. No more VAT. Okay. Cost of laying new concrete slab and installing special rubber mounted footings for the new press in order to reduce vibration during use. Cost of laying new concrete slab, yes, should be included. Hire of a crane to transfer the press from the vehicles to into factory, included. Hire of a crane to transfer the press, yes, included. Vehicles. Cost associated with removing a section of the factory roof to allow the machine to be dropped into place and subsequently refitting the roof, yes, included. Cost of installing soundproofing in the roof at the same time in order to provide protection for workers in the other part of the factory building, yes, should be excluded. Cost of installing soundproofing in the roof at the same time in order to provide the protection, so this is not a significant part for the asset, so this installation done for the other purpose, excluded. Professional fees charged by the consulting engineer for overseeing the installation process, of course, should be included. Electrician fees for connecting the press to the power supply asset, yes, included. A portion of the operating cost, salaries, office expense of the purchasing department should be excluded. Cost of materials, papers and inks used in the calibrating the machine and setting it up for the operations, yes, included. Cost of training the operators of the new machines. Cost of training, no, cannot be excluded. A portion of the inefficiencies in the production for the first month of the use while the operators became comfortable with the use machine. A portion of the inefficiencies in the production for the first month. Of course, it is excluded. Cannot be added to the cost. included 1, 2, 5, whatever that we discussed earlier. So we will see the next question. A Limited has carried out certain works on various machines in their engineering plant, which manufactures high quality metal patterns and templates for use in industry. Determine each case whether the cost of improvements can be added to the existing carrying value of the asset concerned. Okay, number one, the cost of annual machine overhaul, which will maintain the originally assessed standard of performance of the machine for the coming 12 months. So it will maintain the standard, it will maintain the originally assessed performance, standard performance. It will not increase the future economic benefits. So it cannot be added. No, answer will be no. Whether the cost of improvement can be added, no, the cost of this cost of improvement cannot be added. Number two, the cost of repairs to press machine which was damaged by the emergency services while trying to extricate the arm of worker who had become trapped in the press. Okay, this is impairment of loss. Yes, this cost can be added. This cost can be added in the existing carrying value. So when the insurance claim received, compensation should be deducted. That point should also maintained. Number three, modification to cutting machine which will increase its rate of output from 500 to 560 patterns per shift. Yes, when there is a future economic benefit is there and the standard increases, the performance increases, then it should be added to the carrying amount of the asset. Modification to the lathe which will replace the current water cooling system with an oil based system, thereby extending the life lathe by forecast 2 years. Yes, of course, this can be added. The upgrading of a cutting machine with a new software which will improve the accuracy of its measurement and cutting tolerance by number of microns, thereby rising the quality of output. Yes, it can be added. Alterations to the production line which will allow automatic feeding from the machine to the next one in the production process, thereby removing the need for an employee to manually load the second machine. Yes, future economic benefit is there when the cost can be cost is reliably measured. That can, it will be added to the carrying of the asset. First point, no. What is the first point? Annual machine overall, original asset. No, this may not be capitalized as subsequent expenditure since it merely maintains the originally assessed standard performance of the asset. Impairment of loss, that is cutting of arm, should have been recognized when the damage occurred, and any insurance payment received as compensation should have been recognized as income in the statement of P&L when received. When expenditure is incurred to the restore the asset, such expenditure is added to the carrying amount of an asset to the extent that is probable that future economic benefits will flow to the enterprise. Third point, yes. Fourth, yes. Fifth, yes. Sixth, yes. This all should be added. Next question. An entity bought a plot of land for development of office building. So their main activity is to develop the office building, property development. Development of the land was scheduled into 6 phases. The land scheduled for development in phases 5 and 6 was leased to another entity on a short-term basis as a parking lot for heavy vehicles. So this can be incidental to their property development, correct? Main thing is property development. This can be incidental. What is the treatment of rental income from car parking lot? No, this will be considered, it should be credited to the P&L. Because it is incidental. Rental income from the car lease is recognized in the statement of P&L for the period. The car park activity is incidental to the entities. It is incidental to the entity's principal activity. What is the principal activity? Property development. So these are the incidental activity, these are the principal activity. Operations that are incidental to the construction or development of property, plant and equipment are not necessary to bring the asset to its working condition for its intended use. If these are intended to bring into its working condition, then it can be added. Otherwise, no. It is incidental. The income and related expense of incidental operations are recognized in the statement of profit and loss for the period. Next question. An entity acquires the right to use underground cave for gas storage. So they are selling gas. So for purpose for a period of 50 years, the cave is filled with gas, but substantial part of that gas will only be used to keep the cave under pressure. So this is a minimum gas required to keep it under the cave under the pressure in order to able to get gas out of the cave. Okay, we can divide into two. One is for sale, one is for keep under the pressure. It is not possible to distinguish the cash that will be used to keep the cave under pressure and the rest of the gas. So we can divide one, this one, and the rest of the gas. Rest of the gas, evaluate whether ES10 would apply or ES2. ES10 will be applicable to the rest of the gas. That is for the sale. Depreciation has to be charged. This can be treated as a inventory. That is required. No. Total volume of gas must be virtually split into gas held for sale, correct, and gas held to keep the cave under pressure. The former, that is this gas held to keep the cave under pressure, accounted for AS2 as inventories. The former must be okay. This has to be kept as a inventory. The latter must be accounted for PPE. AS10. So this should be treated as a asset. This is ordinary course of business. They are selling. So this will be considered as a AS2. This will be considered an AS10 because this is a asset. The asset is which economic benefit is given and not for sale, rendering service or producing. Asset held for producing goods or providing service. So first one cannot be the treated in AS10. This will be a considered an AS10. This will be AS2. Correct. An entity operates an oil refining plant. An entity operates an oil refining plant. For the refining process to take place, the plant must contain certain minimum quantity of oil, same related to above. This can only be taken out once the plant is abandoned, impaired, and would then be polluted to such an extent that the plant's value significantly reduced. Evaluate whether AS10 would apply. Yes, of course, AS10 would be applicable. The part of the crude that is necessary to operate the plant and cannot be recuperated or can be recouped but would then be significantly impaired even when the plant is abandoned should be considered as an item of PPE under AS10 and amortized over the life of the plant. So these are the some questions with regard to AS10. Thank you.